I take a lot of pride in what I do. This is a line of defense for people, and people don't really understand that until you can't drink. So nobody wants to get sick, because that's the first thing that happens if you don't have clean water.
A news story broke here in the Wilmington area, and it talked about high levels of PFAS in the water, and specifically the class, you know, known as Gen X. A lot of us were trying to figure out, okay, what is going on, what's the problem, where is it coming from, and what's the solution? PFAS, it's a non-stick compound, whether it's Teflon, the lining in your pizza boxes, if you are washing clothes, it's gonna start into the water source. There are detrimental health effects that are occurring from it. Even if we could shut down the point source, because of the environmental accumulation through the years, the only way really to attack the problem is really to look at a filtration solution. So think
of all the other things. I get a call from Senator Michael Lee. Jeff, I'm hearing a lot about PFAS, Wilmington, Gen X, we're ground zero. What would you do? I literally threw out a challenge talking to the chemistry department at a faculty meeting and said, our state, like many others, has a PFAS problem, and we would love your brilliant minds to focus on novel ways to get it out of the environment. Frank Leibfarth came to me and said, hey, I've been thinking about your challenge. I've got an idea.
If you want to take a data-driven approach, what do you even need?
I did come up with an idea on, you know, leveraging these fundamental chemical interactions to remove PFAS from water selectively. And I proposed it to Dr. Warren, and he ended up giving us enough funding to fund a student in my lab for 2 years to start getting some initial results. Dr. Irene Manning, who was a graduate student here in the chemistry department at UNC, and developed effectively all this technology that we're talking about.
We got really good initial results. Even just looking at the first two data points, you sort of knew, like, oh wow, we're actually making materials that work really well. We spent a lot of time doing control experiments and trying to find the best materials we could to compare against and test in really hard water. You reach a milestone and then it's like, okay, well, what's the next thing we need to do? How can we make this something that's relevant to people and practical and could actually be implemented? We started working with Professor Orlando Cornell's lab in environmental science and engineering at UNC, and the engineering team who's testing the material and making sure that it's actually going to work in the pilots.
This project has taken me out of the lab to learn from water treatment utilities. Currently, we are running the accelerated pilot in OWASA, so the next step will be to use that information to take decisions on the final design of the full-scale pilot.
This is the finished product of what was in that large reactor.
This new filtration technology may prove to be the most efficient, reusable method to capture PFAS, but to take it from the lab to at-scale testing needed a really significant investment.
This is a problem facing our state, actually facing the nation and facing the world. We've got these brilliant minds at the University of North Carolina that really have invented something spectacular. And now we're at the point where we're deploying full-scale pilots at a wastewater plant, a water treatment facility, a water well. We're one day closer today than we were yesterday. We're also one day closer to the next big idea.